TheZachman18 here. Welcome back to TZM TV Channel 18. It is time for another episode of Learning with TheZachman18. Today is Friday, April 20th, the 111th day of 2012. 255 days left in the year. Let's go to today's highlight. In 1912, Boston's Fenway Park hosted its first professional baseball game, while Navin Field Tiger Stadium opened to Detroit. The Red Sox defeated the New York Highlanders 7-6 in 11 innings, and the Tigers beat the Cleveland Naps 6-5 in 11 innings. Also on this day in history, in 1812, the fourth Vice President of the United States, George Clinton, died in Washington at age 72, becoming the first Vice President to die while in office. In 1836, Congress voted to establish the Wisconsin Territory. In 1861, Colonel Robert E. Lee resigned his commission in the United States Army. Lee went on to command the Army of Northern Virginia and eventually became General-in-Chief of the Confederate Forces. In 1889, Adolf Hitler was born in Brno, in Austria. In 1912, author Bram Stoker, the creator of Dracula, died in London at age 64. In 1945, during World War II, Allied forces took control of the German cities of Nuremberg and Stuttgart. In 1968, Pierre Elliott Trudeau was sworn in as Prime Minister of Canada. In 1972, the manned lunar module from Apollo 16 landed on the moon. In 1978, a Korean Airlines Boeing 707 crash landed in northwestern Russia after being fired on by a Soviet interceptor after entering Soviet airspace. Two passengers were killed. In 1992, the Freddie Mercury tribute concert for AIDS awareness took place at London's Wembley Stadium. Comedian Benny Hill died in his Greater London flat at age 68. In 1999, the Columbine High School massacre took place in Colorado as two students, Eric Harris and Dylan Klebold, shot and killed 12 classmates and one teacher before taking their own lives. In 2010, an explosion on the Deepwater Horizon oil platform leased by BP killed 11 workers and began spewing an estimated 200 million gallons of crude into the Gulf of Mexico for nearly 3 months. 10 years ago, the world's top economic powers meeting in Washington agreed to intensify efforts to combat terrorist financing and also adopted a plan to better deal with international debt crises. And finally, 1 year ago, the U.S. government announced new protections for air travelers when airlines lose their bags, bump them off flights, or hold them on the runway for hours. Thanks for watching today's episode of Learning with TheZachman18. I'm TheZachman18, and make sure you guys stick tuned for the final world of Yumi and the Cubes today, as well as this week's weekend celebration. And I'll see you guys later.